About to get into another vlog. I want to give a shout out to T Smith. I see you and I appreciate you. You and I is dope. It may not mean much to others, but you be the first one. You and okay, this is about you right now. Be the first to be on the vlog, and I appreciate you very much. Thank you for taking the time because you don't have to. 9 o'clock Monday to Friday, you could be somewhere else, but you choose to be here, and for that, thank you very much. I see you, cast crew. Y'all are amazing. Let's get into this vlog. Catch me on the vlog doing regular shit. SARKAZZ vlog. Well, it hasn't rained again. Is it playing by itself? I'm watching the new Law and Order with Stabler. Are y'all anyone y'all watching it? Let me know what y'all think. Why is that like something playing, but the TV's on pause? Camera, you gonna get the face tracking together, bitch. Been watching this movie called Monster. I wonder what the verdict's gonna be because they just showed the instance. Well, if you didn't watch it, spoiler. He was framed for a robbery. Turned murderer. He was blamed to be like the look, like and like be the lookout. But it did show the clip at the scene where it happened. And I mean, if you ain't see, you should see it Netflix. He said he was the signal. Someone said that they saw him give like a signal. Okay, what's the verdict? Oh, they're about to give the verdict for him. I don't know. That scene is like, He looked like he gave a signal. Like he's like he gave the signal to them to the people who was gonna rob them, and then he raised his hand to block the sun. That's what it looked like to me. What they gonna say? What's up, y'all? Happy Mother's Day. It is 9:52. Just spoke to my mom. They're getting ready to go to church. Before they got vaccinated, I was a little more like, I mean, they grown, they're gonna do what they're gonna do. But of course, I was like, I had a lot to say, like, what the hell, you ain't vaccinated, you, fuck. But they vaccinated, you know, wear your mask too, so I feel a little bit more at ease. Yeah, I want to go to church. It's Mother's Day. Go ahead, go there. Go to church. She said she'd be done by 1, so I'm doing jerk chicken. I'm going to put it in at 12. I was trying to decide. Don't want it in the air fryer, in the oven. Why is that? Put it in the air fryer. Yeah, man, I'm about to edit this quick review. And bada bing, bada boom. Been saying all my happy Mother's Day to my people. Thank you for the supply. You're welcome. Yeah. But I hope you had a happy Mother's Day. Hope your mother, your grandmother, your auntie. I keep saying, I'm so used to your auntie, your uncle. But who knows? Yeah, anyway, like I said. Catch y'all later. Good timing because I was watching them on watching the live streams from the church where they go to make sure. Perfect timing. When I was coming up, they had just got home. So that's my chicken. What's this? Oh, potatoes. How many kind of potatoes he making? Yeah, two different potatoes. Okay, that's different. So I think this is a recliner. How it work? It worked. I don't know how it works though. I don't know how it works. Huh? I want to give you a flower.
And this is for from the seniors group.
Okay. I gave you a list on. Oh, that's cute.
So this is,
more stuff to hang. Okay.
More book. Was it puzzle book?
Okay. Interesting. So how does I'm 45. How's it be? How's it feel being a mother for? Well, I'm 45.
Feel good. Cause when I think of it, there are so many people who wants to be.
Mm-hmm.
And there are many who, when the time when they some people definitely, when they were growing up, or things like that, they never want. Like when I got married first,
mm-hmm.
I said that I don't want to. I didn't want to have a child. Say like for a few years
mm-hmm.
after I got married.
Mm-hmm.
But then I got married at 27, right?
Mm-hmm.
And usually being a nurse and a midwife, they always said if you're 20, after you reach 28 or something like that,
mm-hmm.
they call them your elderly prime. So that means
after what age, you said?
In England, after 28.
Okay, because it becomes a little more difficult to have a child.
They believe, said, it's just the child. Because in those days, it's not like now people will wait until they are 30 something to get pregnant.
Mm.
They believe they're in your 20s, you know?
Mm.
You should start having your family. So, my extra mask again. So, after. I said to myself, wait a minute. There are some women get married and they want to get pregnant, and sometimes it takes them a long time because sometimes there's some adjustment and, you know?
Right.
And things like that and so on. And I said, after a while, I said to myself, well, wait a minute. Me, so I'm going to wait for so long, right?
Mm-hmm.
And thinking all that. Suppose when I'm ready.
You can't have.
You can't have any.
Or it takes a while.
Eh?
Or it takes a longer time.
Yes, I'm saying or something.
Get started now.
Get started. And one day.
So how long were you married before you started?
So one day, I said nothing was at work. I was working on labor and delivery, and he came to me and said, really, you know something? Forget it. I was six, how many months after? So then after,
you said months?
When I came home, the evening, I changed my mind. So what? You said, I don't know if I can get pregnant.
Mm-hmm.
And might wait, and during the final candy, by the time them fixers are supposed to fix it too late.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, thing. And then I got married March 68. Mm. And Michael, June 69. So that's what, a year and a half?
Okay.
That's how you go?
About.
I think it was about a year and a half. And the funny part of it, when
what are you looking for in the bag?
I'm looking for what I've never had to take out before. Mm-hmm. Just to throw it back into another bag.
Uh-huh.
And you were due on September... September 12th or something or another. So God bless him, because when you don't know, you don't know. And he called me one day and said, guess what? The date we are going to do the C-section, your baby going to lose 1 year out of school to the time the school year start here.
Okay.
If I do it September 4th or 5th, which I will be writing the school years. In the school day. And I said thank you because I didn't know that.
That's cool.
Yep. And so that's why you come to my time.
So, so from a child till now, what kind of person am I? Do you find me to be good? So 45 years and, you know, raising me, and here I am a grown, an adult. Like, what are some of your joys or some of your your thoughts on?
There's more joys than, like Pastor was preaching today, and he was talking, he said that he was preaching from Cain and Abel, you know, and he had this lady that gave, before he preached, talk about a son that he lost, and he was saying, don't care what happened. And he said, any one of you in here today, if you're not even in the reach of your mother, whatever it is, give God thanks that it's a blessing, it's a plus. You're rich because you've got a mother and you've got children.
Mm-hmm.
And being a mother, being a parent is not easy. Especially in this country when you have to work.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like when parents were staying at home and take care of the kids, you know what I mean?
Mm.
And to see everything like that and so on. Growing you all up, one, there was pluses and things. It was good that I didn't have to send you all to any babysitter.
Mm.
All the babysitters coming to you, you understand? But then, looking back in life now, but we couldn't have done better because I had to work and your father had to work. And when I started working first, it was when I was on the day shift, it was very hard because you would get up in the morning and the day shift was before you come. It was with Michael. When you come, it was evening shift.
Okay.
And things like that. So it was easier then for me to go. And it's true, Michael, why I went on evening shift. So that I will be at home during the day until time, probably a few hours before the father come in, and things like that. But you didn't have to go anywhere. You come in and think this girl, Sonia, is Mr. Brown's nephew, and things like that. It's been trying. It's been rough. But you know, I was looking back the other day and I said, God, to God be the glory. I was looking back and to see where we came from, the struggles and how we have made it thus far. And to know that God has been so good and God has helped us to grow the two of you. Perhaps there are other things that we could have done and didn't do it, but we didn't neglect it because we knew it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because when I grew up, after I left my mom and went to England, if I didn't have my uncle's son there, because my father wasn't that family orientated, you know what I'm saying? So most of what I did was what I learned for myself. You know what I'm saying? And from others who I thought of older people than myself. So looking back sometime, I said, gee, you know, I could have done that better than that. But I said, God, you know, I didn't know better. So I don't hold it to my, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm saying.
In kind of way. But it has been, but through it all, God has been so good. He has helped up, you know. I looked back the other day and I said, from the time we start, you born 1975, September, we owned our house 76. Must be, how much do we move away? May. Until this day, 2021. Once our mortgage was late, and it was your father's fault. because he forget to put it in the mail on time. So it's been struggles, it's been thing, and I know you come against a lot of obstacles and in your way and in your life and whatever it is, but God is still God, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And God is in control, and God is going to take you through. And you know, last night, as soon as I finished prayer and get up, it just dropped in my spirit. When the song here came to me, when the something, oh, just to me. And the way it seems so dark, God put a rainbow in the cloud. You understand? So I'm praying. I pray for the two of you, not you know alone, every day. And ask God to direct your path. It's impossible because you've got your life to live. You understand? Mm-hmm. So it's the same thing with Michael. I try to work with him as much as possible when I had to ask him. Mm. But you do more than Michael. I know that. You understand?
The person that I am and you know me to be, mm-hmm. you know, what type of person you think it would take to, you know, be with me? Like if you were making, you know, take out, you know, if you were making a checklist of this person needs to be this way, I have this or da da da, to be with my daughter, knowing how Samantha is, this is what they need to come with or be or try to be.
That's a hard one, Samantha, because they have to come just like you.
It can't be. They don't have to be just like me.
I mean, not 100%. Because
I don't know, because I'm like, you know, there's only one me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, not 100%, but...
What do you mean? Explain. What do you mean just like me? Like, what is the just like me?
You're very particular in your ways, in the things that you do.
Everybody's particular in their ways. Can you be more specific?
Especially...
excuse me.
I remember we were talking some time ago, and... somebody was talking about your cleansiness. Who it was? I think it was Ivy.
Mm.
And she reminded me about the incident when it was some of them girls they cooked dinner for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
And it was in the summer and they were in the kitchen eating. And by the time they finished eating, all the place they watched them finish to eat. And then when they were going out, the landscaper had just done the lawn. And when they got to the gate, they see a piece of paper. And when they come back and ring the doorbell and say, Samantha, there's a piece of paper on the lawn. And you go out and go pick up the piece of paper. So, you see, you're never going to find nobody like you. Because most people now, this young generation, they're nasty. They're not tidy. They throw down. You see, like I come from church, you know, and we take off me something, you know, we put them back where they belong, where so yeah, I take off, we hang up the dress, we put my wig back, we put the coat back,
yeah.
Let me take off my outfit, we put it back,
yeah.
Everything like that. Some people come and they
just chuck it everywhere.
And then then they have to go sort out and replace it now. So, you know,
So that's it. They gotta be. That's the only thing that has to be clean, like somewhat clean, like me.
Well, they're not going to be like you, but have to be, you know.
That's it. My cleanliness. There's got to be clean. Nothing else.
Yeah, clean. I mean, you know, you, I mean, to be. I mean, I like the way you're organizing your future, so that you can be independent. You don't have to depend on anybody. And that's one thing I learned from my mother. It embedded in me. Try to be independent so that nobody can have it over you. Say if you don't buy your panty, you can't wear your panty. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And the you have to know you're choosing life to make things work. It's very hard now, because most people now, they're looking to see what you have, what they can get, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's not like before. He's like, what I can get out of this person.
I told Michael yesterday, I think I'm just getting another dog. I just call it a day.
I'm
tired of the dog and just call it a day.
Mrs.
Anybody would know if I'm down.
Eh?
Anyone, I mean, I don't hide my feelings. So anyone could know I'm down.
You know, that's why there's certain times.
Mm.
I just said, I walk up, they call it, you know, I walk on chocolate. I know how to abound and to abase. I study you. And that's why sometimes I even said to your father, I asked him, I said, not because Samantha lived downstairs, Samantha is a big woman. Not because she's your daughter, she's a big woman. And I did the same thing again, and he still not get it yesterday with Michael. One of them is like Samantha, you know. So we said, you have some of them now. They live with their parents in an apartment.
Mm.
And these parents help them go through college. And when they finish, they don't even say, you don't expect them to live with you all the while. Some of them don't come back.
Mm.
Those different, but those who are still like in Brooklyn here,
mm,
and used to live with their parents and thing, good God, when you pass something, even a few months, help your parents, you know, and think, because she been to, but they move up about a rent apartment with friends and thing like that.
People, good morning, happy Monday, 8:16, on my way into work. I hope you had a great weekend.
I did.
Yeah. Face up here. Stop it with the face tracking. Shit. Anyway, let's get this day started. I go to Ascend Lower. For those of you who have no idea why I'm laughing, because I don't understand. Ascend means to go up, lower means lower. The school is called Ascend Lower.
Oh, 7 off work. It was a good day. Busy Mondays are always busy catching up on, you know. I mean, even though, I know people be sending emails at 6 o'clock, so y'all late, it's the week, go to bed. But it was busy in the first part of the day, but I like that because it makes the time go by fast. Mondays and Tuesdays usually go by quickly. Very rare. I'm just trying to fix my cord. Very rare they drag. About to go stop by my godmother real quick and then head home. Yeah, buddy, let's get on the road. Guys, we're gonna close out this vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. I really enjoyed putting this vlog together. It's memories like this. This is why I do this. Yeah. This Mother's Day was different. A lot of shit is different. But anyway, guys, y'all are amazing. I really appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for taking the time to hit that like button. For leaving comments, all that good stuff. You don't have to, and I'm really appreciative that you do. Appreciative.